of the challenge is really, it's not development. The challenge is marketing. It's making sure your idea will solve a problem.
At the Flutter Ghana event, I had the incredible opportunity to ask Ford Fabacha, a tech industry legend and co-founder of Seek Unique and Digital Pomegranate, with over 35 years of experience in tech. Ford shared valuable insights on the ever-evolving world of technology and the power of Flutter for mobile app development. Let's find out what he has to say. Your name and your role.
So my name is Todd Faubacher. I'm the CEO of many startups. Everything from Digital Pomegranate to Seek Unique to Triviomatic. So I'm a coder and I like to create, you know, several startups a year. That's what I do.
How did you get into tech?
So originally, I'm very old. I've been doing this for 37 years. So originally, I started as an engineer. So I'm actually a industrial engineer. So I got into tech as a way to actually control factories. And then I learned how to code, and then I went from there.
Okay. So for someone who is new into tech, how do you explain Flutter to him as a new, in the simplest way?
So Flutter is simply a development language to create apps for mobile and for web. These are apps. So not necessarily web pages, they're web apps. So you develop apps that are going to be used by businesses or organizations that want to manage a business or a process on an app.
Okay. What advice, one piece of advice will you give it to someone who is getting into tech? Especially the Flutter development, which is the mobile app development.
Start small. Just start with the hello world, then go from there. Do piece by piece by piece. And the second thing is solve a problem. If you say to yourself, you know what? I know that people want to know the price of tomatoes, right? If there's a demand and people say, you know what? I want to know who's got the freshest tomatoes or who's got the best tomatoes. Fine, then write an app for that. They will, if there's demand, you have to make sure that people want it, right? And you say to yourself, well, who's interested? Well, they also are interested in restaurants. You know, there's companies making hundreds of millions of dollars writing reviews for restaurants. Maybe someone wants it for tomorrow. You have to find what people are interested in.
Okay. What are some of the challenges you faced?
Most of the challenge is really, it's not development. The challenge is marketing. It's making sure your idea will solve a problem. If you're not solving a problem, no one's going to buy your app and no one's going to use your app.
You know? How did you keep yourself updated when it comes to like new features, like in the tech industry, new features coming into the mobile app, like in Flutter, in other stuff? How do you keep yourself updated?
Well, you always. So first of all, in this business, they make you keep up, because if you're doing the same thing you did 5 years, you're going to be dead soon. That's just the way it is. So Flutter itself also has new versions, and you have to update as they update, or your app will just die. So you don't really have a choice. In this industry, the industry will pull you forward. You have to constantly update.
What are some crucial skills do you need to build a SaaS application?
Mostly you have to know how to do the mobile app, and also you have to understand the database, whether you're using something like Firebase or a big full API system on the back end. You need to have the ability to go both sides. You have to, and a SaaS application is both an app and the database server.
Okay. Why should someone pursue a career in mobile app development?
Well, I mean, because you have to have a passion for it. You have to be able to want to create a UI, an experience for a person. And, you know, you have to have that creativity. Why does someone want to paint a painting, right? So if you think about mobile development, it's what Da Vinci has always imagined. It's a mix between art and science. And really, using Flutter to develop mobile apps today is his dream of mixing art and science. Because you can have a great app that works well, but if it's not attractive, nobody wants it. It has to be user-friendly, it has to be attractive, it has to get people's attention. If it's ugly, it's a failure.
Okay. What are some, like, a promised salary that
a new person get when he gets into mobile app, like the salary ranges?
So the salary ranges depend on your skill. You know, listen, mobile development and mostly app development is like playing on a football team. If you can get the ball in the goal, you're a Messi. If you can't, then you don't make the team, right? So the salary range is just like the football players. You get some that make the top, and you get other ones that don't do well. And so the normal, I think, starting range for people in different countries is about 1,000 US. Now, when you get really, really good, even in countries like Armenia or Ghana, I mean, you're making 5,000 to 6,000 US dollars a month. You know, but that takes experience, and you have to be good.
Thank you. Wow, that's awesome and truly inspiring. If you enjoyed this conversation, then you are going to enjoy the next video. Peace.